The SVTV Filmmaker Interview Series is brought to you by Roche Winery and Tasting Room at 122 West Bain Street in Sonoma.
I'm Rick Love for the 2014 Filmmaker Interview Series at the Sonoma International Film Festival, conducting our interviews here at Roche Winery on the Plaza. And I have with me director Geoffrey James, whose short film Check Please played in the Humor and Heart series. After a relaxing dinner, two proud men battle over who gets to pay the check. And I'm sorry to put you on the spot like this, but dude, what are you, 12?
Yeah, I'm actually 16.
So you are by far the youngest filmmaker I've interviewed so far in the interview series. So tell us a little bit just about how you started making films.
Well, I think it was in about the third grade that I was introduced to iMovie. Mm-hmm. On an Apple laptop, and ever since then I started making YouTube videos just on an old Apple G4 MacBook that I got for my birthday, and so I started making these home videos that I would post on YouTube, and then in about 2011 I got the idea I wanted to take this a step further, so I wrote, directed, and produced a documentary about professional yo-yoing. Mm-hmm. Called The Game Has Changed, and it went to a local film festival that I did, and it actually got a Best Student Documentary.
Oh, fantastic.
So that kind of drove me to go for it even more, and then I decided, do I want to do documentary or do I want to do narrative? So I decided to do narrative and kind of take that next step, and then in 2012 I did a short called Marty, which was about a guy who was stuck in the 70s and whose goal was to open up a record store. Mm-hmm. But gets distracted when he meets the girl of his dreams. And then this past summer I did Check Please, and here we are.
So what's it like on the set with actors who are two and three times your age? How does that work?
Yeah, it's a strange dynamic, and but I think once you really get going and once you start really working and starting to do some takes, all the age differences between me and the cast and me and the crew, it all kind of fades away because we're all working towards that one goal of just making a good movie. It was more in pre-production that it was more evident when I was calling these people and kind of, telling them I was young. Mm-hmm. Not exactly telling them I was 15 actually at the time. But then eventually they'd find out, and if they were cool with it, then that's great. And it sets up a good relationship. If they're not, they're gonna, kind of be, you can tell kind of over the phone whether or not they respect me. And if they don't respect me on the phone, they're not gonna respect me on set. Right. So that's kind of how I filtered.
So people, even before casting starts, you got people who are in and they're in. And one of the things about making these films is it's such an intense amount of time. You really kind of don't have time, I would imagine.
Yeah, exactly.
There. It's a great looking film, Check Please. And the dynamic of the check is something that I was thinking about after watching your film. Because when you're in your teens and your 20s and you're a guy, you're always trying to get out of paying the check. But then something happens about 30, and all of a sudden you have to pay the check, and you're just as invested, maybe even more so, about that. So it's interesting from your young perspective. Had you seen that dynamic in place?
Yeah, I mean, I definitely, it's evident just kind of whenever you go out to dinner with someone else that's, I guess, not in your family. Although I have heard a lot of people telling me, coming up after screening, saying, me and my brother do this all the time. Mm-hmm. And these are guys that are in, their 50s. But I think you're completely right that there's kind of, that switch where then people are expected to pay the check. And it's when you get to a certain age. But this particular story came from actually a dinner that I had last March with my parents and some family friends. And everything was going great. We were telling jokes and stories, and then the check came. And everything completely changed. And there was it was different than it usually is.
It's the end of The Good, the Bad, and the Ugly or something.
Yeah, yeah. And there's the usual let me pay. It's no, I got it. But it went on for 20 minutes, and it got really out of hand, and some of the things that were said are actual lines from the movie.
Really?
I'm
going to punch you in the throat.
No, there weren't many threats, but there was, I remember that the dad of the other family had said, stay out of this, and it was just kind of really rude, and it was So I kind of took that and just kind of ran with it and wrote the script the next week.
Yeah, it's a great, because you can easily see it's already kind of absurd in real life. So you just up it to, you could see taking it to nuclear proportions there.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a very interesting story and a very unique guy thing. Like, when women see it, do they think, like, I don't understand?
Well, it's interesting because, like, I actually got, we were at the Cleveland International Film Festival last week. And someone from the local community college actually asked me if I could use the movie for her psychology class and to teach about the differences between men and women in those situations. And I think that if it was just two women out to dinner or even four women out to dinner, that wouldn't have happened.
They would have split it four ways.
Exactly. So, I mean, I like that ending. Where the women handle it and they can see past all the immaturity, and that's why I mention in the log line that it's two prideful men, because women seem to be a little bit more clear-headed when it comes to that whole thing with the battle of pride.
Well, then it makes you wonder, was it adversarial from the beginning and everyone is just keeping that that inside? Because these people, it sounds like you had the same experience. Everything is nice and everybody likes everybody.
Yeah.
And then all of a sudden it's like, where did all the animus come from?
Exactly. And I think that's kind of what I tried to do setting it up in the beginning. Because the first couple lines, I think the first minute or two is just them having a great time. And it's evident.
Well, you had to establish that, because otherwise you wouldn't have the 180 to it. Which, in a film that is 9 minutes long, you kind of get to get it out there.
Yeah, really. Yeah. It's definitely a challenge when you're making a short to kind of keep the story tight. Yeah.
And in casting, it's interesting to me, because one of the guys is a jock type.
Yeah.
You picture him as a jock in high school, and the other guy looks more like the math club type. So is that kind of what you were looking for, the dynamic when they were... And they were in?
The guy who plays Gary, is actually my 8th grade English teacher. So he was the first guy I brought into the project. I knew that he could act because I do a little bit of acting at my school. And in my middle school play in 8th grade, he was an assistant director. So it's I knew that he could act from him saying lines, especially in auditions. Mm-hmm. And he had been in my previous short film. So it was really for me to try and find the right balance between the two, and when casting the other guy, I had to look for someone that contrasted with Jamie as in a good way, and kind of made it so that the back and forth wouldn't be so one-sided. It would be more like night and day, you know. Mm-hmm.
Well, it's interesting because there's different kinds of aggression, because
those
two guys in high school, it's a very different story, but once they've kind of made their place in the world, they actually are on much more equal planes. So the film is Check, Please. Director Geoffrey James, thanks very much for coming and speaking with us today. I'm Rick Love for the 2014 Sonoma International Film Festival Filmmaker Interview Series here on SVTV 27.